What's up, everyone? Today I'm reviewing Give Yourself Goosebumps number 42, All Day Nightmare. Now, this is the last book I'll be doing an individual review for in this werewolf review-a-thon that I'm doing with Michael Goosebumps Fan and Goosebumps Completionist. So there will be a few books on my ranking video, which will be uploaded, I don't know, maybe a couple days after this video or so. Sometime soon after, I'll do a ranking video. But yeah, this will be the last individual book review I'm doing for this series of books, and it just happens to be another Give Yourself Goosebumps book. Now, like most Give Yourself Goosebumps books, or all of them actually, I've read these multiple times when I was a kid. There's a few that I don't really remember much at all, though, and this is one of those. So it's always exciting for me to go back and revisit these ones that I have very little memory of, because it's basically like reading it for the first time again. So yeah, I was excited going into this one. Now, the premise of this is you wake up in this big, old, creepy house, and you basically have amnesia. You have no idea why you're there, you don't know your own name, you have no idea what's going on or anything. So that's the setup to this story. Now, the first couple of choices you can make will split you into three different story arcs. So most Give Yourself Goosebumps books have two main storylines with a bunch of different paths branching off of those. But this one has three main story arcs going on here. So there's quite a bit going on here. There's a nice variety to this book. And I will just say right off the bat that I did enjoy this one for the most part. I did have some issues with it, which I'll get into in a moment. But first I'll talk about the things I liked about this book, and I'll explain the story arcs a little bit without giving any spoilers or anything. So one of the story arcs is aliens. You basically discover that there's aliens that captured you, and they're the ones that erased your memory, and you're basically just trying to run and survive and escape these aliens and kind of figure out what's going on at the same time. And there's just a bunch of different ideas and paths that branch off of this idea. So I enjoyed that story arc. It wasn't bad. It was okay. The other story arc is you find out that your secret agents working for the government or something, and there's these guys in black suits and like military guys that are after you, and they're the ones that wipe your memory. And then there's this weird machine called the Slammer, I think it was called, and it like transports you to different locations. It's kind of wild and a little bit confusing. But yeah, it's like this whole government conspiracy type plot that's, I don't know, it's different, I'll just say that. And then the third story arc, and my favorite story arc in this book, is werewolves. Now, this story arc, you basically discover that you are a werewolf along with this other kid you're trapped in this house with. You guys both wake up and have amnesia, and you're trying to figure out what's going on. And then when you make a certain choice in here in the beginning, you discover that you're werewolves, and there's just a lot of different decisions that play off of this idea and things you can do as a werewolf. There's one choice in here where you have a chance or an opportunity to possibly be cured and be turned back into a normal human, or you can choose to stay a werewolf. So there's just some interesting decisions that kind of play off that idea. I really like that one decision. It kind of gets you thinking. It's a lot, those kind of decisions I tend to like a lot more than just simple, do you want to go right or left? Those types of decisions where there's really not a lot of thought behind them. But yeah, so I'll talk about the story arcs a little bit. The werewolf one was definitely my favorite. I do feel like it could have been explored a little bit more, which I'll talk about that some more, because it kind of ties in with some of the other story arcs a little bit. But I did really like the werewolf story arc in here. That was my favorite one. There was a lot of interesting choices. The endings for me on that story arc were kind of mixed. Some of the endings were funny, entertaining, but there really wasn't any good, like, happy endings with the werewolf story arc. With the other two story arcs, there's at least one good ending and then just a bunch of bad ones tied in. And I do like that format. I like having one good ending per story arc. It just makes it feel more satisfying when you reach that good ending. Excuse me. At least that's the way I look at it, because that's, to me, kind of the goal when you're reading these books, is you're trying to survive or face up to these threats and challenges throughout these books and trying to find like that good happy ending, but also having fun and being entertained by the bad endings along the way, because there's always a lot of humor behind them. So yeah, the secret agent government conspiracy type story arc, that one was probably my least favorite. That one was definitely my least favorite, as a matter of fact. It was just kind of confusing, and there was a lot of paths that kind of overlapped with one another. For instance, you would make one choice, and it would kind of intersect with the story later on if you were to make another choice. Like, the past eventually kind of reached the same spot, and that happens a lot with that story arc. It's actually in here with all the story arcs. There's at least one path that kind of overlap with a path later down the road. But the Secret Agent one was the worst. And I don't mind when these books do that, where they have paths that kind of intersect with one another. But I don't really like it when it becomes excessive. Like, that Secret Agent government conspiracy type plot line, whatever you want to call it, that one just did it too much for my tastes, and things just got a little bit confusing, and I wasn't really all that interested in that plot to begin with. So, yeah. And the endings on that plot also were not very satisfying. There is the one good ending, but I don't know. It was just okay. It wasn't terrible, but it wasn't really holding my interest like the other two were. And then the third story arc, the one with the aliens, that one wasn't bad. That was actually the first story arc I explored. Not really on purpose, like I said. I didn't really know what I was getting into when I started this one. But that just so happened to be the first plot line I stumbled across, was the one with the aliens. And so I explored all the different endings in that plot, and that one was fun for the most part. I enjoyed it. Not quite as much as the werewolf one, but a lot more than the secret agent type one. So I enjoyed it. The endings on that one too were kind of mixed, but more solid overall than the one with the secret agent. So overall, the endings were very mixed with this book. Some of them, like I said, some of the bad endings were very entertaining. There's always a lot of humor behind the bad endings, but the good endings left a little bit to be desired, in my opinion. There was only really two for sure good endings that I can think of. Like I said, the werewolf story arc didn't have any for sure good endings. There was a couple that could be debated as being kind of good endings, but not really. I don't know. But anyway, yeah, that's just kind of a mixed aspect for me. The endings in here, some of them are really good, as in being entertaining and creative. Others, not so much. One thing, too, I will mention about this book, I almost forgot to mention this, is there are some errors in here, like technical errors. There's one decision you can make in this book, and I believe it's with the secret agent story arc, I want to say. I can't remember now. It might have been the werewolf one, actually. But there's one decision you make at a point in this book, and it tells you to turn to a certain page. And when you do, that page has nothing to do with what was taking place in the story. Like, it's just a simple error. It tells you to turn to the wrong page. And I think I found in here where the page was that the book or the author intended for you to turn to, and it kind of overlaps with another path previous in the story. So that's just a simple error. And I also found, I think, one or two grammatical errors in here too. So I think this book just kind of suffered from poor editing a little bit. And going along with that, I also think the secret agent, I'm just calling it that because I don't know what else to call it, the secret agent story arc, I feel like that one went on for too long. That almost felt like the majority of this book, to be honest. I would say 40% of this book is the secret agent story arc. And then the 30%, the werewolves, and then the aliens was the other 30%. So, and the secret agent type one was my least favorite. So I feel like they could have cut back on that, especially because just a lot of the paths just overlap with one another, and it's really not all that interesting to me. So I really wish they would have cut back on that more and then got a little bit deeper with the werewolf story arc and explored that idea more, especially with there not being a super satisfying ending. Some of the choices and decisions you make in the werewolf story arc are really creative, really thought-provoking. They're not just simple, you know, do you want to run left or do you want to run right? Do you want to fight? Do you want to hide? Those kind of decisions. They were more unique and thought-provoking, such as, do you want to stay a werewolf or do you want to try to cure yourself? Like, I was really interested in that storyline. I was having a lot of fun with it. I just feel like it could have been explored a lot more than it was. So, yeah. I think that's about it, guys. There's probably more I wanted to say about this book, but off the top of my head, I can't think of what it was. But anyway, I enjoyed this one for the most part. I think this is a pretty solid Give Yourself Goosebumps book. I think it did suffer a little bit from editing issues, and there's some things that I wished were different about it. Again, that werewolf story arc was a lot of fun to me. The alien one was pretty good too. But yeah, if I had to rate this one from 1 to 5 stars, I would probably give it, I'm thinking on the low end of a 4 stars, maybe like in between 3.5 and 4 stars, maybe like a 3.75 or something is probably what I would give this one. I enjoyed it for the most part. It was pretty fun. Not one of the best Give Yourself Goosebumps books or anything like that, but this was a pretty decent one. It just had some issues, and I didn't really care for the whole government conspiracy storyline that was going on, so. And it just had too many intersecting paths for my tastes. And again, the endings were very mixed. A lot of them were very entertaining. Some of them not so much. So, yeah, guys, I think I'm just starting to repeat myself a little bit at this point. So, that's about all I have to say for this one. Thanks for watching this review, guys, and shortly after this video is up, I'm probably going to do a ranking video ranking all of the Goosebumps werewolf books from least favorite to favorite. So, thanks for watching, guys, and keep on the lookout for that video. Peace.